Welcome to Postscripts here on Fox 2. It's our weekly look at news and politics with our newspaper partners at the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. Joining me in studio, as always, Christopher Ave. He is the national and political editor at the Post. And also with us today, David Carson. He's a photojournalist there. Gentlemen, great to see you. Appreciate you all being here. First time we've had you on the set. We've seen each other in many, many stories out there. So he has an interesting story. We're going to talk about that here in just a second. Well, a photograph taken by David is getting a whole lot of attention this past week. As most people know, crime is out of control in St. Louis, so as journalists, we never know what we're going to see when we arrive on the scene. And for many people, the picture here seemed to strike a nerve. Fox 2's Jaron Jordan has that story.
From the super moon setting beyond the Gateway Arch to Superman strolling down Washington Avenue, St. Louis Post-Dispatch photojournalist David Carson has seen it all.
You're looking for moments that can tell a larger story.
And if a picture is worth 1,000 words, this one is priceless. Carson snapped it Monday afternoon at the scene of a homicide at the Peabody housing complex just south of downtown.
It's sad for the mother who lost a child. It's sad for the child that lives in the environment where people are being shot.
There have been three fatal shootings at the Peabody complex in just the last 30 days. Carson's photo showing a toddler wearing a diaper and socks surrounded by crime scene tape and evidence markers makes a strong statement about the continuing violence plaguing the city.
He lives in a world where sirens and crime scenes and police collecting shell casings outside his front door is a regular event.
Carson says when he snapped the photo, he thought of a piece written by his colleagues at the Post-Dispatch when writers Nancy Cambria and Lori Scrivan penned a series of reports on traumatic toxic stress and the long-lasting effects violence can have on young people.
You think about adults living in it, it's rough on adults. You can only imagine the effect it's having on these, you know, young children. How does a two-year-old process the fact that a man, shot and killed outside his front steps?
Carson's job takes him to the front lines of wherever news may be. Today it was a triple shooting near Goodfellow and Sherry. But with every story, he takes with him the responsibility to always show the bigger picture, pictures that last long after the headlines.
The city is not just all violence and crime. There are lighthearted moments. There are funny moments. There's good people. There are bad things that happen. We do have a problem with gun violence. But that's not the only thing the city's about. The story hasn't stopped. The story continues to evolve. They always do.
Like we said, David is here with us today to talk about that. Why do you think that shot in particular with the young boy caught the attention of so many people? Why so impactful?
I think it's just, you know, anytime you have a young baby at a crime scene, it's something that's sad to see. And in this particular case, the baby's actually inside the crime scene tape because the shooting actually happened right outside his front steps. And, you know, it was something that was unsettling for me to see as a father, and I wanted to make a picture that captured that and shared it. And it was one of those pictures, too, that it's not technically perfect. He's a little bit in the distance and stuff, but the emotional impact of seeing a young child there at a homicide scene, you know, it really began to have a greater impact on me the longer I looked at it, and then it kind of, other people online began to like it as well.
Yeah, I mean, Christopher, you see these pictures all the time. When I first saw that one, I'm like, it's just that gut, God, wow. And I don't know what you were looking for in that shot, but those kind of things are, I don't want to say magical, but it's impactful is the word when those happen.
Exactly right. I mean, the old cliche, right? A picture's worth 1,000 words. It's really true in some cases. I think what the image shows is the juxtaposition that we have here in St. Louis of the innocence of youth, you know, and the everything that represents, bright beginnings and a future ahead of them and all that. And then, as you see there, you know, the crime tape and the reality of daily violence that citizens, residents in our city, in our area, live with, and not live with every 6 months or even every month, but every week, almost every day. It's kind of stunning how that happens. Life still happens, as you said in the piece, David, but it's got to be tough when you are growing up in that environment.
Mm. I will say this, David and I used to see each other on stories all the time when I was out on the street reporting more, and you just never know what you're going to see pulling up. What do you look for when you're going up to a scene? Because it's different from what we do. We're looking for the whole scene. You're looking for something in particular. What is that?
I'm looking for something that is unique and tells a story within this homicide. Unfortunately, we have so many homicides at the city that so many times, you know, they do begin to look alike, where you're just standing behind yellow tape. And so you're looking for something that is slightly different that can speak to a bigger story. And in this particular picture, this child standing behind this tape speaks to issues of poverty in the city, and this is people's living conditions. And, you know, we have not had a chance to speak yet with his mother. We've been trying to speak with his mother. We've gone back to do follow-ups. We've not been able to reconnect with her yet. But we have a story in Friday's Post-Dispatch where we're going to be talking about life over in the city, because there have been three homicides within 100 yards of where that baby is standing in the last 30 days. So
wow.
there's just too much shooting, too much violence going on in our city. And I think what you have there in that picture is it shows who it's impacting the most. It's these young children. And that should upset you. I want that picture to upset you. If that picture doesn't upset you, there's something wrong
right.
with you.
Yeah. Now, David, you've worked in St. Louis for how many years?
17 years.
17 years. You're a Pulitzer Prize winner. You won that prize covering Ferguson, the aftermath of the killing of Michael Brown. We just saw that anniversary this mm-hmm. last week, the third anniversary. Here's my question. You touched on this in the piece that we watched, but your view, you know, you're out there every day covering not just homicides, but life in St. Louis and its surrounding communities. Where are we as a community now? What is your assessment? I mean, we talked about the violence and the crime and the problems in the piece you mentioned, though, but there's life, there's hope. Give us a sense from your perspective.
So my job as a photographer is to cover my city in its entirety. One of the things we are wrestling with in the city is a problem with gun violence. But that does not define our city. That is not the only thing that St. Louis is about. There is a lot of beautiful things that happen in this city. There are some wonderful people that happen in this city. So you have to make sure your coverage is not just all one-sided and skewed towards this negative violence that happens in the city. It is important to cover, and we should cover it, and I will continue to cover it. But at the same time, it's important for me to go back to these neighborhoods where some of this violence takes place to document good things that are happening in that neighborhood, because there are good things that happen in that neighborhood as well.
You know, one more comment before we let you go on this one is, that's one story of many you've covered over the years. And I was trying to remember if it was the two of us out at a crime scene. It's when I was on the street at 3:30 in the morning. Our crew pulls up. It was either you or someone from the Post-Dispatch shows up. So again, 3:30 in the morning, three people dead, bodies are still laying there, and the entire community is out. And there are kids everywhere looking at this. And the one thing that stuck out to me is, if that happened in my neighborhood, everybody would be hiding. They'd be in the basement. Yet it's so common in some of these neighborhoods that kids that age aren't even shocked by going outside and seeing dead bodies on their street. It's sad, but it's a reality for a lot of people.
Yeah, you know, the Post-Dispatch did a large story on toxic stress, written by Nancy Cambry and photographed by Laurie Scrivan last year. And when I saw this young child out there, I'm like, well, this is toxic stress. This child is growing up in an environment where there's been three homicides within almost 30 days, within right outside his front door. He's used to seeing police come and process crime scenes outside his front door. That is not something that most of us experience. That is not something that children should experience. And I will continue to make pictures like that when I see them, because I wanted to speak to the broader issues that we have within our community.
All right, you do great work. Appreciate you making time for us today. Great to see you.
We'll see you soon.
All right, well, of course, we all know crime is a huge problem in St. Louis, not only from the standpoint of victims, but also from the perception outside our area that we're the most dangerous place in the country. We'll talk with Post-Dispatch reporter Christine Byers about what the city is doing to combat those issues straight ahead, right here on Postscripts.